The gematria of Bryant has everything to do with Giannis being a five life path, with the NBA Finals ending in five games, the Lakers over the Bucks have five letters, Laker five letters. It is Yana and Giannis that have the same first five letters. And the interesting thing about the Lakers winning four out of five games in the NBA Finals is that that is a winning percentage of 80. That has everything to do with Bryant's five rings, because it's Bryant that equals 80. The percentage, the win percentage in the NBA Finals of 80% corresponds to the gematria of Bryant. Four games to one, once again, has everything to do with Kobe Bryant's gematria equaling 41, with the fact that this is the 74th NBA Finals, that the King has gematria of 74, that the fact is that King equals 41. In Los Angeles, California has gematria of 41 as well. I just forgot the S there. And now we don't have that 2-3-2 format, so it's two games at. Who's got the best record in the league? I apologize. Okay. But Bucks have the best record right now, so it actually begins at Milwaukee, as a matter of fact. So the NBA Finals ends at Milwaukee. LeBron wins two out of three at Milwaukee if the Bucks were to finish with the best record in the NBA this year, which most likely is the case that the Bucks are going to finish with the best record. King LeBron wins two out of two at LA. King LeBron winning two out of three at Milwaukee. The gematria of Bryant in the win percentage, which means that the Milwaukee Bucks win percentage is going to be 20% in the year 2020. Giannis Antetokounmpo is pick number 15. It is Bryant that is gematria of, or rather, it's Kobe that is gematria of 15. So one win in five games for the 15th pick, Giannis Antetokounmpo, in the NBA Finals up against King LeBron James. This is another explanation as to why I am for certain sold of the fact that the Lakers are gonna win the NBA Finals in five games over the Bucks.